Hey, what's up, my friend? Mike Robertson here. And if you're anything like me, you probably can't go 3, 4, 5 days a week heavy anymore. In the gym, that's totally okay. So how do you set it up for a weekend warrior to make sure they're getting the absolute most out of their training while also finding ways to hit those training sessions when you're freshest and you've got the most energy? We're gonna talk about that right here today. And today, we're gonna dive in and talk a little bit about how we can set up a training week to maximize our sessions or get the most out of our training sessions when we have the most energy. So let's be honest here, if you're grinding out a 40, 50, 60 hour work week, chances are you probably don't have a ton of energy during the week to get high quality training sessions in. So we've gotta be smart. When can we train to maximize our performance in the gym? So here's a couple strategies. I'm gonna give you two options today, hopefully one of which will work for you. So we've got option one here, and so let's write our work week out here, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Like, if you're going through your week and you're absolutely crushed at work, you're probably not gonna do much Monday, Tuesday. But let's say we gotta try and get a little bit of a session in during the week. You don't wanna go 5 days without working out. So let's say Wednesday, we go in the gym and we just punch the clock. We get a little bit of stress on our body, whether it's a squat, a bench, a deadlift, some sort of big bang compound lift, get a little bit of work in, right? And then we know Thursday, Friday, we gotta kind of grind it out and get through that week. And then Friday, I don't know about you, but Fridays for me are like magical. I always sleep well. So then I know on Saturday and I know on Sunday, I can go in the gym and I can push it. Those are gonna be my main training days. So it's not uncommon for me to have Saturday be my absolute best training day of the entire week. So you can see what we're trying to do here. When you've got the other stressors in your life, whether it's work, school, whatever the case may be, when you've got all these stressors, you're not trying to add a lot of extra stress to your system. However, when you get to the weekend, you've got a little extra downtime, you can fuel your body appropriately, you can get enough rest. Now, Saturday, Sunday, those are gonna be our bigger training days. So that's one way you can do it, and it works really, really well. Now, here's a second option. If you don't wanna sit, you know, for most of the week, what you can do is, again, let me recreate my week here. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Let's say Saturday, Sunday, we know those are gonna be our big days, right? And Sunday is generally never quite as good as Saturday just because we trained hard the day before. So let's say Monday we go in, we get through work. Tuesday, we just wanna punch the clock, right? We come in and we do a quick or brief workout. For me, some days on a Tuesday, I'm gonna do 3 sets, 8 to 10 goblet squats, 3 sets, 8 to 10 push-ups, and that's a wrap. I'm gonna call it a day. Wednesday, I take off. Again, Thursday, I punch the clock again. I get a little bit of stress in my body. I get moving. If nothing else, I go in, I do my resets, I do my warm-up, and I do 1 or 2 exercises. So again, what we're doing here is we're trying to just facilitate or stimulate our body throughout the week, knowing that we're not trying to push the gains during the week. Pushing the gains is for the weekend. So regardless of which option you choose, whether it's just going one lift during the week, maybe two, and just going a low intensity session to try and facilitate and stimulate your body, either one of these options can work really, really well for you if you wanna push it on the weekend and you wanna consolidate that stress to when you have the most energy and you have the most juice, basically, to go in the gym and train. So I hope this has helped you out. If you have any questions, any comments, please leave them in the comment section below, and I'd love to answer them and help you out.